Needless to say, the organization could not be happier with his play during this incredible season. From a player nobody wanted to a player nobody can forget, it's been quite a journey. Okay, we'll open up the floor to questions.
How does it feel to be the best basketball player in the best basketball league in the world?
I feel thankful. It's a very humbling experience, but honestly, this is a team award. I share this with my brothers. This is for them.
Come on, honestly, how does it feel to be the king? It's gotta feel good, right?
Honestly, I don't think about personal awards or ego. It's playoff time. Whenever I leave this podium, I'm going to go join up with my teammates, and we're going to start working towards our goal of winning the world championship. That's what really matters here. That's my goal. But I am thankful. Now, if you excuse me, got some work to do.
Yo, what is up, everybody? The playoffs are here today. As you guys see, Danny Tice did win the MVP for the season. I forgot to show that stuff in the previous video, so I'll show like all NBA first team and defense and all that, defensive player of the year, all that stuff at the end of the video. But for now, we're focusing on this game because that's what we gotta do, man. It's playoff time. No more playing around. We are going against the Dallas Mavericks in the first round of these playoffs, and early on, Danny Tice pulling up a perfect release. I believe that's our first shot of the playoffs and our first make of the playoffs. That was a guaranteed make right there. Klay Thompson, that might as well be a guaranteed make from downtown. Klay Thompson off to a good start, and that is always good to see because, you know, regular season and playoffs are different, are a whole different animal, man. You never know who's going to show up and who's not going to show up in these playoffs. I got to make sure Klay Thompson is ready for this. Iguodala is a veteran, so you know he's ready, and he's knocking down the three that, for some reason, I didn't get an assist for, and we'll see. But so far, Klay Thompson's off to a good start, so that's always good as we find Steph Curry, and Steph Curry is ready. He's Steph Curry. He's ready. That's guaranteed. And Steph Curry was more than ready early on in this game as we find Curry open for three, and Curry knocks it down. He was off to a quick start in this game, so near the end of the first quarter, you know who we're looking for, Steph Curry. We move his man away from him, set a little kind of moving screen, but it's not called, so we gotta worry about it. And Curry knocks down the shot again near the end of the first quarter. I'm looking for Curry one more time to beat the buzzer. He pulls up, and Curry knocks it down again. Steph Curry was on fire to start the game, and that might be an understatement. We find Curry to start the second quarter, and he still had the stroke, mid-range, long range. He had it all going on early on in this game. We're up by, we have their lead doubled right now, and Curry's trying to do even more damage. The bounce pass to Harrison Barnes, who slams it down. 20-point Warrior lead, and we are just destroying the Mavericks. But this is a Maverick team with Chandler Parsons injured. Parsons was coming off the bench. He was playing limited minutes, and Dirk Nowitzki had like a bruised knee or something like that, and he is out. So, I mean, Nowitzki's injury is like for 1 to 2 weeks, so he could be coming back any game in this series, but he did not play in this one. So that's big for the Mavericks, and they have to rely pretty much solely on Monte Ellis to provide offense for them. But that was working because Monte Ellis did not really know what, you know, how to miss. Pretty much he was making damn near everything, and he was keeping them in the game when, you know, a 20-point game could be a 30-point game without Monte. And Klay Thompson was making sure that was still a 20-point lead when Monte had all his answers. The shooting guards were just playing all offense, no defense, as we didn't force a turnover. So I believe Iguodala forced the turnover, and we were able to get the bucket as Jameer Nelson near the end of the shot clock just thrown it to Monte Ellis. And Ellis, like I said, I mean, this dude did not know how to miss. He was 9 for 13, 3 for 3 from downtown. Monte is not known for, you know, being a 3-point sharpshooter like that, but he had everything going on in his arsenal. The pump fake, the drive to the rim, all working for Monte as we find Klay Thompson. And Klay always had an answer. That was the good thing about this game, because the Mavs are putting up some serious points in this game. It's just that we're putting up a ridiculous amount of points. We nearly have, like, what, 70 points with, like, 3 minutes into the second half. So that's a lot, as we find David Lee, who makes a beautiful cut, takes it to the rim. And, you know, that's the problem with the Mavericks. I mean, it might be even worse with Dirk on the court, but they do not play defense. And it's been the known problem with the Mavericks for this year. Who's going to defend for them? It's not going to be Monte. If Chandler Parsons comes in the lineup, it's not going to be him, as we pump fake and draw the foul on Tyson Chandler. Chandler's the back line, but that's pretty much the only guy out there who, you know, can possibly defend on the court. So, you know, we're just probing into the paint. There's just no one there. Once we take Tyson Chandler out, Everyone else is just scrambling, and we're able to find the open man most of the times. But the Mavericks, well, like I said, they were scoring at a rapid pace. Not Jameer Nelson. That's Raymond Felton coming off the bench. He's feeling the stroke, and it's a 5-point game. This was a 20-point game. The Mavericks have chopped the lead down on the road. They're coming here to play. They're not going to be a rollover in this series. They want to fight, and this is just 2K playoffs at its finest. They are not missing right now in this third quarter as we take it all the way to the rim there and slam it down hard. But, you know, our offense was just on fire throughout the game, thankfully. Because if it wasn't, we would be in trouble because the Mavericks were just... look at Steph Curry. We got 91 points after three quarters. We should be blowing them out, but Monte is just keeping them in the game. And look at Monte over Iguodala. Thankfully, he doesn't get it to go, but Tyson Chandler there to rebound and put back the miss. 11-point game. Monte ended his shot clock. I'm going to make sure he's not taking the shot there. We block it, and we start a fast break here. Nice bounce pass to Harrison Barnes between Crowder and the other man and Aminu. And Aminu's forced to foul Harrison, and Monte Ellis is... Dirk's not in the game, but Monte's going to try to make us remember Dirk's, you know, stole part of basketball. Bad part of basketball history by hitting that one-legged fadeaway as Harrison Barnes getting a few buckets early on in this fourth quarter. That's always good to see because, like I said, we need all the offense we can get, including this three from Iguodala, but Iggy can't knock it down, and we can't really put him away, but thankfully, you know, they chopped the lead down to five, and we did extend it a little bit, so that's always good. They gave us a challenge. It's always good to be challenged and, you know, respond to the challenge well as we get a perfect release here with under 2 minutes to go in the game, so... You know, they gave us a scare, but we should be coming through with the victory here. Granted, nothing crazy happens in the last minute of the game as Klay Thompson makes sure we're going to win this game. The lead is back up to about 20 points. They finally went a little bit cold. Monte finally missed a shot or two and stuff like that. But meanwhile, we were just not missing, period. Both teams shot, I believe, like over 60% in this game. It was unbelievable shooting. We almost scored 120, and we came through with the game one victory here. So leave a like on this video if you enjoyed us coming through with the victory in game one. You see Denny Tyson 11 for 14 shooting and 24 assists. My teammates were on fire in this game as well. Klay, I believe, had like almost 30 in the game. Monte almost had 40 in the game. And you guys can also see like the All-NBA first team, second team, third team, and all that stuff. Denny Tyson also won Defensive Player of the Year and was on All-NBA first team and All-Defense first team. So Tyson was putting up numbers. So leave a like if you enjoyed it, and I'll catch you guys next time.